the number one thing I'd have to say to people is to just get out there and explore. Because when you explore, you find a passion. And when you find a passion, that's where the drive comes from.
This is going to be your general, average 21st century human being just looking at life.
Sean Tracy, Sean Steller, as you are aforementionedly known, tell me about yourself.
So, my name is Sean Tracy, I'm 16 years old. I live here in County Wicklow, Ireland. Absolutely love it here. And I'm a filmmaker as well as being a full-time student. I'm currently in fifth year in secondary school.
Okay, and you're in the middle of all this Leaving Cert jazz at the moment. How are you finding? Do you enjoy school?
I must say I really enjoy school. So it does, you know, help me out in the leadership way, but also with collaboration, as I mentioned. And this is probably the more relevant one for everybody, because while some people don't maybe sit transition year and, you know, some people don't play school sports, I think collaboration is going to be a constant part of everyone's education. You're always collaborating with different students and projects. You're reaching out to people to maybe help you with that homework question, or maybe you're giving them the homework question. And there's just always a sense of discussion and communication between teachers, students.
How has your secondary school education geared you for your already busy working life?
It'd have to be discipline. That's the thing. Since, you know, kind of before I really got into working seriously with filmmaking, whether it be YouTube videos or, you know, making short films or documentaries, before I had like that official kind of work, what really was happening for me was school. Because although I was making YouTube videos all the time, it was sporadic, it was loose. I didn't have any structure to it. I could stay up till like whatever hour making videos some nights. But school really prepared me for having a deadline to get something done, getting it done in that amount of time, getting it done to a good standard. It just taught me that discipline.
Sean, you are in the midst of a very important schooling year at the moment, schooling years. How do you find the Leaving Cert in terms of catering for people like yourself and people who have interests in the arts, in music, in culture, and sport?
Mm-hmm. Well, I'd have to say, obviously, you know, there's the discipline, the hard work aspect, which I've already mentioned, but there's also a sense of collaboration and leadership that you get. I think with the arts, especially like for me, if I want to get into filmmaking with directing, what you need is a sense of conviction in yourself and also the ability to convey that conviction to others, your ideas clearly, and to motivate them and get them ready for what you want to do as well. And I find that the Leaving Cert does help me in that regard, because, you know, specifically in a year like fourth year, where I had the opportunity to get on stage and I ended up being TY Boy of the Year for rugby in previous years. I got to be the captain a few times of my rugby team, and although they're so small looking back at the time, they're such big deals, and they do give you the opportunity again to be a leader in an environment. So for me, hopefully that will prepare me for when I get into the industry when I'm older, when I'm trying to convince other people of my ideas.
The biggest thing that stands out to me about yourself, Sean, having met you, is how busy you are, both inside and outside of school, and how motivated you clearly are to have all those hobbies and to be so busy doing everything, basically. There's people out there your age who aren't feeling that maybe at the moment, or in general, particularly with the books and the studying. So what advice would you give to them?
Well, the main thing I would have to say to students that maybe aren't feeling that inspiration, that kick to, you know, wake up early in the morning and get started with their life, the thing I would have to say is get out. The best tip I would have is to just explore all the different activities that can be out there, because while I do have a passion in filmmaking, if it weren't filmmaking, I'd probably be doing something in language learning. Because when I discovered learning Spanish and how much fun it can be when you pursue it yourself and kind of approach it your own way and maybe mix that in with the way you're studying it in school, it can become so exciting.